gentlemen, how you doing? It's John the Ninja live in the dojo, aka the Dojo, aka the John the Ninja Studios. And you know this, man, it's good to be back with another concert resume video. And for the first time in a long time, guys, I get to tell you with a big smile on my face, this concert resume video is not only the most recent concert I went to, but it is a concert I was actually able to do promo for. I was there live talking to the fans, backstage doing my thing. So let's get into it, guys. 100% without a shadow of a doubt, what a kick-ass show this band just performed in Reading, Pennsylvania. I'm out of words. The band was DragonForce, and when I tell you stupendously how great they were, woo, big words cannot personify how amazing, how well put together this band has everything. And I mean everything. Even though the drive to Reading, Pennsylvania from where I'm at was 2 hours, I guarantee you, I am a witness myself, it was worth every single second. DragonForce has everything mapped out, from the openers, to the stage show, to the lighting, to the crew, everything. So let's get into it, let's explain, and even better, because this was the first live event coverage I've done in a very long time, I even filmed some of the day, so we're going to be going back and forth between me and some events that happened that day. But let me start off by saying, number one, gotta say thank you to the PR reps for DragonForce. Absolutely lovely to work with. Wonderful people. No name shall be given out. I must keep quiet industry secrets. But everyone straight from the PR rep who I emailed right down to the tour manager. Just nothing but great hospitality. Even the merch table. Before they even knew I was there doing promo, even the merch table was amazing. I ain't even going to let his name out there. But go visit my man over there, because I'll tell you, he was great too. So let's get to it. DragonForce was coming to Reading, Pennsylvania. Always wanted to see DragonForce. I knew of DragonForce prior to them having the song. Yeah, of course, everybody knows it, so I'm not going to say it. But before they even had their song released on Guitar Hero, I knew of DragonForce because there was a guitar magazine called Guitar Player, and they featured them. And, you know, I loved the idea behind them, but I couldn't really appreciate it yet. You know, I was just a purist. You know, I only want to listen to, you know, the metal bands I'm growing up with. So, of course, Metallica, AC/DC, Iron Maiden, you guys know. But my respect for them grew when I got to college. That's when I really started diving deep, deep into DragonForce. It was Maximum Overload, which was released in 2014. That was the album that got me going and saying, damn, DragonForce is a reckon. It is someone to be respected, even though it's a band. The Game, and I want to say, hold on, it was probably No More. Yes, No More, because The Game was my favorite song off that album, but No More was the other song that I really dug. And that's where my love for DragonForce really came into fruition. So, of course, pandemic's over, it's 2022, I'm getting back into these bands, going out again, doing promo interviews, and I reach out to DragonForce's reps, ask if they're free. They're super busy, which is understandable, but they say, hey John, you know what, please come, we'll let you do your promo, do your thing, we'd love to have you. And I said bet. So early that day, and let me tell you people, it was a beautiful cloudy day, it ended up raining, but I got there to Reading, Pennsylvania just in time. I got up and I started doing the promo for the video. So I started talking to myself, I started saying all kinds of stuff, and this is basically the walkthrough of what happened. I am going to go see DragonForce at Allentown, PA, and I'm going to show you guys the whole process. I'm going to give you guys a very, very lucrative, at least to me, showing of how I prep and how I get to these shows. So let me show you to my workstation. You can see this is where I gather all my stuff when I have things to do, prepare for the interviews and etc. And this is what I always take to these shows. Now, again, tonight I'm seeing DragonForce. It's a 2-hour ride there. It's a 2-hour ride back. So I'm going to be prepared, and I'm going to be doing all types of promo out there. Going to be talking to fans, etc. But before I get to it, let me show you guys what I do to prepare for this. So number one, no matter what, I always bring my earplugs. I know this is a medicine bottle. You guys know I'm a pharmacy tech too, and a public notary, and a bunch of other stuff, etc. But I always have these. I always have my ears. I've gone to so many shows. I've been around so much loud noise. I gotta protect my ears. I'm just a little worrisome because every now and again I get a hit of a little tinnitus. I can hear it in my left ear. So number two, these are essential.
if not for you, for somebody else to make a connection so you could talk to people, or somebody comes back later and protects you from someone trying to kick your ass and they kick your ass. These are essential no matter what. Always, always have a lighter. Absolutely. Number one rule. Always have a lighter because there's always somebody there smoking. Amen. And then always have a can opener because you never know who you're going to run into. So those are two. Of course, me, I'm the germaphobe. So hand sanitizer is a must. And always have a pen ready to jot down whatever you need. This one's a little bit more personal to me. This is just for protection on the road. A Bible. Now, most people be like, oh, you have to have a Bible so you can preach at somebody or this and that. That might be true, but that's not always the case with these shows. So, more so, the Bible's for me. Little protection, little reading on the way. Another one you gotta have, business cards, your regular cards. Promote yourself, promote your shit if you go to these shows, and your personality, your band, etc. This one, of course, is only me specific because my car is one of the few ones that still play them. CDs, something to pass the time if the radio sucks. Of course, the usual, your charger, your wallet, your phone, which I got in my hand. But the last thing people usually don't do, which I really would recommend, is have a book bag. Have a book bag full of your crap. Whether or not it's extra clothes just in case somebody spills some beer on you. Whether or not you get stuck out there and you gotta sleep in your car. Always bring extra drinks. That's what I do. So that's pretty much the start of my day. Alright, so we got gas. Just left my old job at Wawa. That's the place I usually talk about for the overnight. So now we got a full tank of gas. We got nothing but time when we hitting the highway. So usually when I hit 55, I just sit back, I relax, and I just think. And I remember a lot, I used to do a lot of thinking about life, a lot of music and all this stuff, but I always turn on the tunes. This one, I get to think about, you know, seeing these bands I've seen and traveling and, you know, the work I've been putting into, you know, being able to be a part of this community. You know, DragonForce was no slums, man. They ain't no ANs. They are the real deal musically. They know what they're doing. They're always spot on. And I just remember in college when I first come in, I was a freshman, and I like walked into a guy's room who was playing DragonForce, and I started playing along with them. Started playing Into the Fire and Flames and all of it, man. And it's just really cool how things come full circle. It really is. So while I'm driving there, I get past King of Prussia, and of course I'm sending, you know, just little reminders to people, because here's the thing. I got up, I got ready, I left, I drove, and me being me, I trusted my GPS, and it's been a while since I had to go far with it, so I didn't map out exactly where, you know, I was going. So I took the Commodore Barry, and instead of just going straight to Reading, I would drove closer to Philly and then took the highway there, and I was like, oh, that was so stupid. And then even worse, while I'm driving, and it's not that bad of a drive after that. You get on, I think it was 476, and you keep pushing. After that, I missed a turn, and you guys know, this is true for most of the United States. If you miss a turn on the highway, you're going another 15 minutes before you get to your exit or an exit to turn around. So I was just like, oh, I'm not going to get there in time. But as pissed off as I was, you always got to try and calm yourself. And I remember driving, and I did this for the video. You know, when I missed that turn, I got really cynical in my head. I was like, oh, son of a bee, I'm angry, really upset. But then I remember, you know, calm down, it's not a big deal. Most of the times when I'm late to these shows, I end up getting in on time regardless. So you gotta let God or the universe, or however you perceive it, you know, do its thing. So got there, and when I say it was nice. It was just relaxing. I'm here. I got some time to kill. Doors are at 7. So I got out. I surveyed the land. Other than the fact that there was a Steeler sign, I was like, this feels like a rock concert. There were fans there, wall to wall, and this is what you got.
All right, so as you can see, we made it 2 hours early. We got a bit of a line already. So other than the mess-ups of trying to get here, everything was pretty smooth. The only issue, we may be in Steelers country. But other than that, super excited to see these guys. Now, there's a couple of fans that are blasting DragonForce in their cars waiting. They don't want to be in the line. But the main thing I'm getting is most of these fans are the hardcore, love this band to death, which is great because I haven't seen really too many other people wearing any other band. So we can get to that later. But in the meantime, I'm going to talk. I'm going to wait in line, see if I can try and get some people to do some interviews and talk about their love for this band. But until then, you know what? I might get my jacket because it's starting to get a little cold out here.
So one thing I do remember about this is I had to announce myself to the crowd, so I didn't think I was some weird guy, but the fans for DragonForce. No one talked about any other bands there, and we'll get to those other bands, but the fans for DragonForce, I've never ever experienced a community that had so much access to a band. Every single person, from the regular guy on the corner right down to the VIPs that are closest to the door, every single person had nothing but nice things to say about the band, no negativity, and it seemed like everybody talked to a member of the band. And it wasn't like, oh, we all talked to Herman because, you know, Herman Lee has his own Twitch and etc. But I am telling you, if I were to pull this paper out right now and write down every single thing they said, it'd be pretty much more than this notebook, because I had guys saying like, yeah, I talked to Mark Hudson all the time and he's such a cool dude, and then right back to, I met Sam back in Boston this year and man, we had drinks after, or you know, I'm so happy G was here, he's shown me some licks on, you know, the drums and etc. And it's like one guy was talking about how he saw Alicia with her other band, and it was just 100% breathtaking away, because that means the band is doing it right. That means that band really cares about their fans, have got it when it comes to that fan band interaction, you know, and everybody just feels good. You know, who doesn't feel good when you see your idols and you get to talk to them? So it was just one of those things where you're like, damn it, they did a phenomenal job. So we get to it and I start interviewing people, and here are some of the characters I ran into. Some of these guys are really, really great.
Hey, yo, my name is Jay, and I love DragonForce. I got into it when I was young with me and my friends and stuff. Through the fire and flames, got me through a lot of hard times. Happy as fuck to see this band.
Now, Jay, now I can see you happy. You've been smiling the whole time. I got to ask you about the get-up, man. It is personifying why you're so happy. So tell me, what you roll out of bed, and you're like, you know what? I got to show how I'm feeling, because this is just love right now.
All times, to be honest.
Okay.
Usually, you go to a rock show, you're wearing black, you're wearing jeans or whatever.
As examples show,
many people are in that. I don't think that it matters how you look to go to a rock show. If you enjoy the music, you enjoy the music.
You know what I like about it, though? You were thinking, other than the Spanish music over there, you were thinking, I'm going to be seen by the band. Because everyone's looking all generic.
Everyone's like a sore thumb, yo.
Absolutely.
My name is Elijah Mantilla. I'm here for DragonForce. Let me tell you why they are some of the dopest aspects I've ever seen. Want to hear some sick-ass riffs? They will shred you to next week, my man. You want to hear the absolute killer of bass. Everybody in there will rock your world, man.
I love how you did the little weed sign. Like, listen, you might need a little extra. Might need a little extra. Who's your friend here? He looks familiar. I can't tell if he's like a fighter. You didn't fence back in the day,
Alex,
did you?
Right here. He's one of the best friends.
That's your best friend, Alex?
That's right.
All right, Alex, why is he your best friend? Because he put you on the spot, literally said it. And he brought you to DragonForce. He paid for your ticket, man. So what's happening?
So we vibe over stupid stuff. Like, you know, we music's the biggest one that brought us close. We find out we listen to a lot of similar music.
So what songs are you guys most looking forward to seeing?
That's a hard one.
I'm hoping maybe they play Soldier of the Wasteland tonight, some of my favorite songs.
Oh, my
God. I would say I'm with you on that one. That's probably the one song I want
to
hear.
All right, so, Captain, you look like the guy that every metal concert I go to, you look like the guy that's going to kill me in the mosh pit and then ends up picking me up when somebody else hits me down.
Yeah. Listen, man, I don't throw the elbows. I just push. I just push and I'll help somebody up. But mosh pits are always fun.
So
always
tell me, fun. Are we going to be moshing at this joint? DragonForce is that type of band.
Listen, I'm not going to start the mosh, but I'll tell you what. This guy's going to start the mosh, and we're going to have a really good time.
So when did you get into DragonForce?
So DragonForce I've been into for a couple of years. I really started with a lot of heavier stuff, and then, honest to God, I'm a giant nerd. I started playing Dungeons & Dragons and got into a lot more fantasy power metal and shit. So love them.
Hey, DragonForce Tresser. I'm actually really excited. I was glad to see them. They were really kind to me.
So we got to pull that back. So you met DragonForce?
Yeah, well, I talked to them a bit, yeah.
Okay, but that's not, listen, out of everybody here, okay, me included, I have not spoken to a member from DragonForce, so I'm going to give me that story.
I brought an NES, cartridge of Dragon Spirit, and Herman Lee was excited. He was like, oh my God, I beat this game. Did you ever play it? And I said, no, I was actually going to get around to doing it. But aside from that, they were really nice, too. I wanted to send a video to someone, but like one of my awkward friends, because they were hyped for it, this concert, but they couldn't come this year, obviously, because of certain things going on in life. So then I decided to ask, hey, can we send a video to them? And they were nice enough to let me record a quick video saying, wish you were here. Just to make him happy.
Now that's love, man. That's love. So a little bit more about you. What's your name? Where are you from again?
My name's Jared. I'm over in the coal region. I took like a 1 hour 20 drive here. I'm not going to lie, not wasted any cents here.
That's fabulous, man. Well, give me the devil horns and let them know who you love.
I love Dragon Force.
All right, so guys, I had to stop this gentleman right here. Not only does he look tough, but look at what he's got. Look what he has, and I think that's actual sign, man. Yeah.
Wait, check the back.
All right, that's badass, man. So tell me, what's your name? What's happening? When did you get this beautiful creation?
I'm Jake, and I had this custom made just like a few weeks ago for this specific occasion. And I mean, I couldn't pass up having him not sign it, so.
Okay, so you're part of the VIP package group.
Yeah.
Which I'm not gonna lie, everyone here seemed to have met the band, but me, I'm so confused. What did I miss, man? How was it? Tell me, walk me through it.
It was great. They signed stuff. I had them sign my album. And we got photos with them. They're really awesome to meet, man.
My man on the side, get your friend over here. Get your friend. Look, he's still looking at those photos, but he's a little bit more of a hardcore. Now, granted, Herman Lee's great, but he got the whole band. Look at the fire and flames.
Dragon shoes.
Oh, man. Look at them. Let them shine one more time. Let them shine one more time with the 81. What's your name, family?
I go by Itachi.
Itachi?
Herman's Angie's Discord and okay. From their channels.
All right, so tell me, how long have you been a Dragon Force fan?
Since Sonic Firestorm, Soldiers of the Wasteland.
Oh, they get.
When I first heard that, it was
going in
real good. And then G started playing video games on his Twitch. So I've known G for 4 years, and I've known Herman for 4 years, and it was both on their Twitch channels.
Okay, man.
So I played Fortnite and PUBG with G.
So which one are you better at, Fortnite or the other one?
It depends, because now there's no building in Fortnite.
Okay.
So I'm more of a COD. Oh, we also played Call of Duty together, me and G.
Okay.
And I played Among Us with Herman. They're all real nice people. All of them are real nice. Mark, Sam, Alicia.
And really nice to their fans, what I'm getting. Yeah.
Very nice to their fans.
Man, that's wonderful.
We get inside, and it is a very, very nice venue.
All right, guys. So that was fun outside, getting to meet the fans. They let the VIPs in first. They paid and got their money's worth. I've never seen so many people so excited to be backstage talking about the fans. Even the fans that didn't pay for VIP, man, they had so many stories of meeting the band, so it's definitely gonna be a good time. Inside this Reverb, I'm getting the Philly vibes, even though we out here in Reading, but a beautiful, beautiful setup that they got here. And if you look to my left as we move along, they got the merch tables. We're gonna show you a little bit of Dragon Force, getting the lights ready. And let me tell you, they got a plethora of stuff you can get. And let me show you, reasonably affordable prices. But in the meantime, guys, we're gonna get a drink or two. We're gonna sit back. We're gonna let the fans come in, and we're gonna enjoy tonight's show. This is definitely gonna be something.
Walking in, you could feel the anticipation. These fans are not rabid like they're gonna kill anybody, but they're excited. It's peaceful. It's one of those things that everybody talks about. It's like everyone comes together and it's a great community. So I go walking around, I'm meeting fans, I'm asking them questions, and the one cool thing was there was a guy from where I'm from, Vineland, New Jersey. He drove the 2 hours to go see them in Reading, and I was pissed. I was like, damn, bro, we could have carpooled, but I digress. Basically, that whole time, I was just talking to people, getting their stories. There was one couple where they met when they were in middle school, and there was a mother's son that were talking about how much they loved Dragon Force and how mom dragged her son there. So basically, it was just a conglomerate of people that were super excited to see their first show in a long time. One guy commented he didn't see a show since 2018. He wasn't going to go see anything. And he was around my age. You know, in the grand scheme of things, we're still young considering what the pandemic, what we went through and all that. So he was going, you know what, man, I didn't want to take the risk. But now that everything's calmed down and my favorite band's back, I'm going to see Dragon Force. I was like, yes, now. The one great thing I love is Dragon Force did a great job getting really, really good openers. So the first band comes out, they're called Seven Spires. And phenomenally, their bassist is a guy I mess with. Because anytime you see a bassist with more than four strings, you get very judgmental. you start looking, okay, man, are you going to use all the strings? Are you going to be able to play all the strings? Are you going to get a solo? Are you going to play with your fingers? I'm nitpicking, but that's the jokes among musicians. But they came out and they killed. And it took them, I don't even want to say that long, to win the crowd over. And of course, the lead singer, she's wonderful. I got to chat with her after the show. She's in like 5 bands. I was like, damn, girl, go you. I was confused. Another thing I remember that was very cool is her friend likes Baroness. I like Baroness. They're a great band. But either way, so they come out, the bassist kills, the band kills, they do a phenomenal job playing. And then these treats just keep on coming. So then Visions of Atlantis comes out. And if you guys don't know these guys, they're really, really good when it comes to symphonic metal. And they put on a good show too. They had this hat being tossed around because, you know, they're promoting their newest album that's going to come out, Pirates. So they all dressed up as pirates, and it was a really fun show. They came out and did great, and Clementine has this wonderful voice. She's a soprano, and pretty much they have 2 singers, and they just go off. Wonderful time. It's if I were to liken it, it's like seeing the Dropkick Murphys. The hype behind them is always the fire. You're getting a little bit of everything. You're getting a little death metal. You're getting a little theatrical, musical, you know, really, really well-constructed songs. And then, you know, even cooler after that, Firewind is there. Do you guys know who Firewind is? Firewind is Gus G's band. Do you remember back in the other concert resume videos, I talked about how amazing Gus G is as a guitarist. He played with Ozzy and etc. So now you're going to see the Greek guitar king hero play again. So that was a real treat. Herbie Langas is the new lead singer. So they were great. Herbie even came out with Seven Spires, which was really cool. But Firewind came out, and a lot of fans were just infatuated with the playing. That whole band is just really, really tight. And the thing I love was it's just everybody in the crowd was starting to get closer together. They were starting to, you know, form and, you know, try and get closer and closer. But nobody was, like, hitting or punching or anything. But everybody knew, hey, you know, it's getting close to that time. So Firewind finishes their set. And when I say all these bands killed it, all these bands killed it. But when it came time, and I lie to you not, the mood changed. DragonForce came out and the crowd ate it up. DragonForce didn't have to work for it because they did it prior to with all the hard work they did years prior. But you get the idea. DragonForce didn't even have to try. They came out, the place erupted. And now at this point, this whole place is filled. There's no question about it. This place is wall-to-wall people, and it is on. Now, I'm on the side. I'm at the merch table. You know, I'm talking to people, having a good time. And then DragonForce comes out, so I got to get back to my spot. Now, why do I have a spot? Let's get to it. So while I was waiting for Firewind, I struck up a conversation with a bunch of characters left and right. And just some people that are just really nice and genuine. One guy I was talking about guitars with. I was like, hey, man, what do you play? He's like, oh, I play this. And what about you? Oh, for bass, I play an Ibanez, but I got a Gibson. You know, and then there was another guy there who was in another band himself. And everyone's doing really good. And then there's these 3 people I will never forget for this show. There's a guy on the left, has glasses on, really, really passionate fan. There's a kid. He has to be like 9 or 10 here with his uncle who... I won't lie to you, his uncle was probably like 2-3 people from the side of me, but he was watching him like a hawk. His uncle was like, I don't even think he watched the show the whole time. His uncle was watching him, making sure he was okay, which was smart, and I give him kudos for that. And then there was another guy, he was another kid, he's probably like 13, 15, and he had a VIP pass on. So for some reason, the little kid started talking to me, and he started talking to everybody, and he wanted a pick. He wanted a pick really bad from Herman Lee. So we're like, you know what? We're going to get you a pick. Now, me being the guy I am, having gotten all these, you know, monuments and all this stuff, all these picks and set lists and lighting lists and, you know, pictures and stuff, you know, you kind of want to join in and try and, you know, make that dream come true, make that moment extra special, especially when they're kids. So, you know, I was like, everybody, we got to get this kid a pick. And everybody joined in. It's like, we're going to get him a pick. Let me tell you, this kid made out. But let's get back to it. So the whole point of that story was they saved my spot. So these guys come out and they are killing it. They are still supporting Extreme Power Metal, which was their offering of 2019. That album came out. And of course, everybody knows the pandemic. They were originally going to tour without their drummer G, and they were gonna have another really, really great drummer that actually auditioned for Dream Theater, but thanks to the pandemic and all this craziness, G was able to recover. He was back, their drummer is back, and they're kicking ass. And one thing I loved about the stage setup is they have these giant cabinets that Sam and Herman can get on top of and play, but these cabinets are playing video games. They're literally showing video game clips. They have the band as video game characters, and they're doing their thing. It was really, really cool, especially for me, being the music guy and the video game guy I am. You know, seeing Final Fantasy VII up there, I'm just going to say that was something really, really cool to behold. But when I say again, the musicianship, the technicality, and just the ease these guys are playing with. You know, they used to have a thing back in the early days when Van Halen were playing, they called it teeth metal. Teeth metal? What the hell is teeth metal? Well, teeth metal was a phrase coined because Van Halen were one of the few guys to play and smile. They're like, what the hell? Why are they smiling so much? But Van Halen was having such a good time. And that's what you got with DragonForce. This band was having a good time. The fans were having a good time. And it's just something that you really, really can't recreate. Words can't express it. It is genuinely one of the best performances of a group of people creating such joy. There was a part where we were pretty much in the mist. And there was an older lady with me. And I think her daughter was next to her and a couple of friends. But one of the songs came on. She wanted to mosh. So I was like, okay, I'm not going to hit her. So I was like, you know, let's go. So I go back and forth. She's like, come on, go harder. And starts hitting me. And I'm like, oh, she's one of those. So she's like literally starting a mosh. She's nailing me pretty good. I'm not going to hit her back because I know I was hitting her with like maybe 10%. I was not going to do more than that. I felt like if I hit her with like 40%, like if it was a real mosh, I'm not swinging elbows or trying to punch her or anything. You know, it's just a regular hit and roll. But she was nailing me and she was nailing other people. And we got ourselves a little mosh pit. And I think somebody fell. And we all automatically stopped, picked that person up, and then continued to mosh a bit. But this is what killed me. When an actual mosh pit got over on the side, she didn't go in. I was like, man, this is what you wanted. But I won't forget her. She was nailing me really damn hard. And I got to give her kudos for that. That was really funny. But little things like that. I just want to mention again the fact that everyone stopped in the mosh and picked that one person up. That is concert etiquette, taking care of each other. So, wonderful. Even when things are going wrong, they still handle things perfectly. So there was a guy in the crowd. He was heckling Herman Lee, or he was heckling the band. I'm not too sure. I won't lie to you because, you know, we're all sitting there. We're enjoying the show. I'm more surprised, if anything, that I got my spot back because we're so compact and compressed. So, guy's been doing his obscene things to him, and Herman's like, hey, just because you bought a ticket doesn't mean you can do that to me, okay?
It's an interesting night tonight. So YouTube in the middle, what's your problem? YouTube is causing some problem. Look at me from the inside. What's your deal? Okay, you know what? This is unusual. I have kicked a lot of people out of my chat on Twitter before. But now we have some real life troll in the audience for the first time. Throwing me all this shit the whole night. Security, please remove these two guys. No. Just because you bought a ticket doesn't mean you can come and insult me. It doesn't mean shit, man.
And one of the great things about this was, instead of just kicking him out, Herman gave him an opportunity to change his ways.
Insulting me here, let me kick you out. These two words there. What do you want? You want to sit at the back and be calm and be respectful, or you want me to kick you out?
Yeah!
Thank you. All right. I don't hate to be the bad guy, okay? You know what? I don't have the moderators here. You guys are the fucking moderators tonight. Alright? Thank you.
That was it. So, another thing I wanted to mention that I really loved about seeing this band play is the fact that they have such a great sound mix. A lot of times you go to these shows and you have to put an ear to what you want to hear. You know, sometimes, you know, they boost up the guitars because that's, you know, that's the main part of the song. You know, everybody loves the harmony, and then they put the vocals back up. DragonForce has such a really good sound team, phenomenal, that if I wanted to really tune into something and listen, it wasn't difficult. It was really well done. And the fact that the guitars were going back and forth, they were easily clean to hear. And then even better, the bass. The bass was literally the one rhythm guitar instrument I could hear with ease. This is the first time I've gone to a show where the bass, it was just no question. You got two guitars and the bass is just easy to hear. And that means so much to me, because a lot of times you'll get a bass and guitar, like say the rhythm guitar or the bass guitar, you know, they'll anchor the rhythm of whatever they're playing, and then the lead guitar will go off. But this time, what I really, really loved, and this is what's so great, Alicia, she was heard the whole time. She was holding down the rhythm of the bass and the rhythm of the song, so while the guys are doing their thing on guitar, you know, she's holding it down, and that's what I really loved. I really noticed that, and it was spectacular. And let's throw it out to Mark, because they even give Mark Hudson his own opportunity to play, and he rips that whole damn band's great. And they even more, they brought out a guy from the crowd to play, and they got a guitar tech to play with them, and they did like a little game noodle, which was really awesome. Sam came out and played the banjo while everyone was killing it. And let me say, the tech killed it. They might want to think about making it a three guitar band, because afterwards everyone was cheering for the tech. So phenomenal show. I can't express enough how great it was. And just little things here and there, the guys drinking beer and having like the techs play for them while they're going. Again, I already mentioned the tech coming out and playing. And then the one thing about that kid, he got his pick and then so much more. So not only did he get a set list from Sam, G came out, gave him a stick, and then while all of us are like, yay, you know, the little kid is enthusiastic, but there's little parts here and there. He keeps on asking me, he keeps on asking other people. It's like, hey, do you think I'm going to get it? And it's at that part of the show where you can't really yell, you know, so I told him, it's like, and I gave him some advice. I was like, hey, listen, you know, give it some time. When it's really quiet, call out to Herman. You know, call him out, say you want to pick, see what happens. But, you know, enjoy the moment. And other people were like, yeah, we're going to get you a pick, man. It's going to happen. So, of course, after they do the great bow, get him a pick. And they throw a pick. So they throw a pick to him. It drops. Herman throws another pick, and it's lost in this confetti. Because this band has been shooting confetti. They got a CO2 cannon that's been marksman all over the place with it. It's actually really, really cool. And I prefer the CO2 cannon because, you know, you don't get wet. Which is great. You know, it's not like water. It's like, oh, damn, it's wet and it's cold outside at night. No, it's great. It's a wonderful substitute for water cannons. And, you know, he lost it. So then everybody in the crowd, when the band was done, they start searching. And the kid himself finds the pick. And security gets another pick on the ground and he hands it to me. And the guy next to me, he wants a pick really badly. So I give him the pick. The reason being is because another great patron that night gave me a set list to Firewind. So who am I? You know what I mean? You give, you should receive, you gotta give back. So I gave back, and you know what? The genuine excitement on his face, I gotta bring it back to the MMRBQ when I told you guys about when I saw Slash and he threw a pick at me and these two guys started fighting over the pick and the one guy found it and started screaming, I got it, oh my God, and he was so thankful. That guy with the glasses that was up there trying to get that kid a pick too, he was so joyous. He said, thank you so much. And I hope it made its night. Now, you know, a lot of people are like, why would you do that? You know, even if I didn't get what I got that night, I'm inclined to believe I would have gave it. Now, the sweet thing is, I'm not going to say it was karma, but I may or may not have gotten a Dragon Force pick too later that night. So, but I just want to finish. Let's go back to in the concert moments, just watching this band perform. Jeez, it was a true treat. As a guitarist, seeing the harmonies, because that is my bread and butter. That's what I love. As a bassist, hearing the bass hold it down, such great rhythm. And as a drummer, I gotta say, G has the dream setup I want. The four tom cymbals everywhere. It was a lovely setup. And of course, Mark is a wonderful singer, and he's really good with the crowd. There's a lot of singers that, you know, you can tell they don't really want to talk to the crowd, or they're a little nervous. Geez, Louise, Mark is wonderful. He says everything he needs to say. It's quick. And of course, Sam and Herman, everybody talks when they have their moment, but I gotta give it to DragonForce. Was an absolute force that you need to see, guys. So basically, everyone went to the merch tables, and of course, me being me, I had to go say hello to the guys from Firewind, especially to walk up, shake Gus G's hand, say hello again. You know, it was really, really cool, because Gus G is a guy. There is a guitar lick he did that always stuck with me, and I still play it to this day. It's one of my practice rounds, but it took me forever in college to figure it out. It's probably simplest thing if you have a good ear already, but walked up to him and say, "Hey, Gus, it's amazing to meet you. Want to say I'm a big fan, etc." So after that, I said hello to Firewind again, took some pictures. I went over to Seven Spires, said hello to Adrian Cowan. That's their lead singer, and man, she was a sweetheart. I already mentioned how we talked about her friend and etc. And then after that, me being me, I was very fortunate to be able to talk to Michelle of Visions of Atlantis. And after that, for some reason, I struck up a conversation with somebody because I really wanted to meet DragonForce's tour manager, because the treatment, there's other things that happened behind the scenes while I was at that show that were really, really great. And of course, you know, one of the reasons I got this pick, so I wanted to say hello to him and, you know, express my gratitude, a welcome to Pennsylvania. Thank you so much for, you know, just the great hospitality the band had shown me through their reps. And guess who comes out? Go ahead, guess. Take a second, Joe, think about it. Sam comes out, and for me, I ain't saying nothing against anybody in the band, but every time I listen to DragonForce, Sam happens to be the guy I want to play what he's playing. So Sam comes out, we start talking, and he says this. He says he likes Rick Martel, and I'm like, oh no, because I got a picture with Tito Santana. Oh my God. So if you guys don't know, Mick Martel was a wrestler, and him and Tito Santana were tag team partners, and then they split, and then Rick Martel became, you know, a smartass, basically, like, I'm better than everyone else, and it worked. But it was really cool, because we were wrestling fans, we talked about it, then we talked about guitar songs, and there was another fan that came and talked with us, and Sam said something I thought that was really cool and honest. He said, there are certain songs that people hear all the time, and they're not good songs. And he said, Paranoid by Black Sabbath is not a great song. I might disagree with him. Wasted Years by Iron Maiden is not a great song. And he said, Run to the Hills is not a great song. And I was sitting there like, you know what? As a Maiden fan, I ain't gonna lie to you. Those aren't my favorite songs. I do love Run to the Hills. The intro and the solo, you know, it was great. But, you know, it gets overplayed. So I was like, okay. This board, Wasted Years too, overplayed. But he was like, you know, and he, of course, everybody knows that everybody in DragonForce is so sick and tired of hearing Play Through the Fire, because they're gonna play it. But, you know, I remember one thing I said during the show, and he said that while we were having a conversation, because he said it's a good song, you know, you just overplay it, you hear it all the time. But there's so many more great DragonForce songs. And, you know, we were talking about how, like, the casual fan, you know, only knows the one song and see the rest. But the one thing we could appreciate was that they did not just have casual fans there that night. Every single moment I turned, even out in the parking lot prior to that, you know, I looked and there was a fan singing. It was like when I went to the Wu-Tang Clan concert and there was that one guy, eyes closed, singing every song just passionately. It was the same thing with DragonForce that night. Even the newer songs, they were playing and singing, and these kids, it wasn't one, it wasn't two, it was a crowd of people into it, mouthing the words, Cry Thunder. I'm sorry, that was my song of the night, Cry Thunder. But just a wonderful, wonderful evening. And, you know, me and Sam chopped it up a little bit. And then even better, Clementine from Visions of Atlantis came out and started talking to him, and he said, all right guys, I gotta go real quick. And then me and her struck up a conversation because she has a tattoo on her neck, but she was explaining like why she got a tattoo, and it's a really beautiful story about like how the bird on her neck is a fierce, they tend to be fierce even though they're small, and wonderful, wonderful conversation with her. Me and her pretty much went down the route of singing, because I've done some, I wouldn't say professional voice lessons, even though the person who was teaching me, Alana, which, love you, Ma, she is a professional singer, and she learned classical, and so did Clementine. So we were going back and forth through the exercises, and she gave me a really, really beautiful speech about the love of singing, and it was just tremendous moments. But after that, everyone's pretty much, you know, all the bands are pretty much there. Most of the crowd is left, and, you know, it's just me, and, you know, I'm talking to some of the merch workers, and a guy walks up to me and is like, hey guys, yeah, so they're gonna have the counters come out, and he's looking at me, he's like, yeah, and I can give you the count. I was like, hey, I don't work here, man, I'm here for the show. He's like, look, all right, cool, you look like you belong. So the moment that was really cool was, I wasn't expecting this, but Herman Lee was out there. He was out there, and he was walking by doing his thing. You know, he had the camera on for the Twitch and, you know, cleaning up. And we had a moment where we walked past each other. Of course, who doesn't know who Herman Lee is? And there was a moment where he looked at me, I looked at him, and I said, hey, man, wonderful show. God bless you. Thank you so much. And he said, thank you, dude. And it's one of those moments where, you know, you don't have to heckle them to get the point across. You know, at this point, my phone is dead. Let me put it in perspective. When the show ended, my phone died. No more pictures. My phone dies on me. I get one more fan interaction about how great the show was, and my phone dies. So, you know, all those beautiful moments I just described to you, they're going to be in my mind for the rest of my life. And sometimes it's better that way. Sometimes it's better to just remember, have it in your heart, store it there. And of course, I'm doing these concert resume series, so it ain't going nowhere. But, you know, that was a moment I won't forget, where it's like, hey, sir, you know, how many legions of fans do you have? How many people have you inspired to play? You know, you and Sam, you know, I just want to express my thanks for the beautiful art you create. And he acknowledged it back. So I didn't even bother him after that. And you don't have to. Some fans don't get it. You know, they see them. It's like, hey, you know, can I get this? And then they leave and then come back and bother them again and this and that. You know, there's certain things you don't do. Like bother somebody when they're in the bathroom or eating. Off limits. Gonna tell you guys again, don't do that. But, you know, to have that moment with Herman Lee, you know, that was pretty great. As a whole, I got a gift. 100% DragonForce, a 10 out of 10. A 10 out of 10, guys, a 10 out of 10. And it sounds like I'm repeating myself, but to break character, let me explain. For a 2-hour car ride, which did involve me driving home back in the rain, for a show that was literally years in the making, I gotta give it the 10 out of 10 because, one, the band was phenomenal. To the stage presence and the setup and all the extras you got were great. You go to the merch tent, number 3. Merch is cheap, affordable, and it makes sense. I didn't see anything over $30. I didn't even see anything at $30. Everything was 20 or below as far as I remember. So, fantastic. And most important off, fan interaction. This band loves their fans. This band is great. Again, saying it one last time, from the VIPs to the people in the crowd, regular schmoes, everybody had a story about DragonForce, how they inspired them, or how they knew them. Almost everybody I talked to met DragonForce, had a conversation with them, knew them personally, or whatever. So, DragonForce, 10 out of 10. Not only was DragonForce phenomenal, but their openers were phenomenal, and that's why this concert was great. You got to see great music after great music after great music after great music, one band after another after another after another. It was just a combo that worked. So let's get to it. Let's get to the set list and see how the night ended. When Seven Spires was out first, they did a kick-ass job again. Remember the bassist and all that? So Wanderer's Prayer was 1, Gods of Debauchery number 2, Oceans of Time 3, number 4, Lightbringer, which is where Herbie of Firewind came out, okay, 5, Succumb, 6, Drowner of the Worlds, and 7, Dare to Live. Now, the next one, of course, Visions of Atlantis, and when I say they kicked ass, just remember that. Masters of the Hurricane, A Life of Our Own, A Journey to Remember, Heroes of the Dawn, Melancholy Angel, and Legion of the Seas. I remember how awesome it was that they were throwing the hat around. And kudos to the fan that gave it back, because they came out, Michelle came out with a pirate hat on. He's another lead singer, so they have 2 lead singers. Just remember that, people. And they threw it out in the crowd, and he got it back. But I'm going to say it again. The hat looked good on the bases. They need to put the hat on the base. So next up, we have Firewind that came out swinging with Welcome to the Empire. That's number one. Head Up High, number two. Destination, number three. Number four, World on Fire. Number five was Fire and the Fury. Number six, Ode to the Leonidas. Oh, Ode to Leonidas. Oh, good. That's a good one. I can't believe I messed that up. The next one was Breakaway. Rising Fire was after that. And the last one was Maniac. And to the magnum opus of the night, we go to the cell phone for the many pictures I have of the set list after giving it to another fan. We go into number one, Highway to Oblivion off the new album. Furry of the Storm, number two. The Last Dragonborn, number three. Ashes of the Dawn, four. Video commercial, that's where they use the cabinets, and it was like a Sonic commercial. It was really cool. Heart of Demolition right after that, and then they did the video game medley. Remember the part I said about the banjo and Sam looking like a farmer and the tech? Which, tech, join the band. Kick ass with them. You were great. Black Fires right after that. Cry Thunder, which is the song of the night for me. Remembrance Day after Valley of the Damned, and My Heart Will Go On. Of course, we had that one fan in the crowd. They were like, we got time for two more songs. He said, play this song. And he said, oh, really? No, we're not going to play this song. And then, of course, they played the song that everybody knows, everybody loves, Through the Fire and Flames, to cap it off and end the night. And then the band came out. So, guys, were you at that show? I know I gave a lot of you guys props at that show for the love for DragonForce. Guys, have you seen DragonForce before? Are you going to see DragonForce again? I want to reiterate, 2 hours of my time to get there, 2 hours back, worth every single second for those moments, 100%. If you have DragonForce coming near a tour, if you have DragonForce coming to a town near you, or not even near you, within the vicinity of 3 hours, I guarantee it's going to be worth taking off that day. Guys, until next time, continue to subscribe and like. Thank you so much, because let me tell you see that flat screen right over there? That's thanks to you guys. The interviews I got recently, thanks to you guys. So let's keep it going. So next time DragonForce comes around, I can talk with them. It's going to be magnificent. So guys, as always, thank you. That's number one. Be smart, be mindful, and God bless, guys. Until next time, ninja out.
My man, what's happening?
Hey, you know, I'm just here. My name is Brandon. I'm here to see DragonForce.
DragonForce? Brandon, what do you do for a living?
I sell cars.
You sell cars? You ever sell a DragonForce themed car?
Probably not. I wish I had, though.
Oh, my
gosh.
That'd
be pretty cool.
I think I can see it now, man.
Yeah, that'd be pretty neat.
Who's the distributor you work for?
I work for Toyota.
Toyota. You need to write him right now.
I'm telling you.
Call your boss.
Godzilla was Japanese. He was a dragon.
Man, I'm seeing a connection. If there's one thing you would like to tell the fans, or even the band, what would you tell DragonForce right now?
Keep making the same music you've made since 2005.
All right.
The heavy guitars. It's amazing.
We got another father-son duo, but more importantly, we got a fellow Cobra Kai member.
Oh, yeah.
A black belt. Sir, what's your name?
Don.
Who's this right here?
My son, Isaac.
Isaac?
Going to his first DragonForce concert.
Oh, Isaac! Look at him! He's ready to go! How proud are you as a father, as a mentor right now?
This is probably one of the better moments of our
relationship
at the moment, so real good.
Do you realize what your father's doing for you right now? Like, years from now, like, me and my dad had the worst relationship, man. Every store I got that's happy, Ozzy, AC/DC. But you're seeing the definitive musicians, DragonForce. Tell me, what's running through your mind with that?
I'm actually pretty excited to see them. He's told me a lot about them, and he's played a lot of their songs, so I can't wait.
That,
it's going to be a great experience.
That, tell me, man. When you saw that they were coming here to Reverb, what was your first thought? Did you just buy the ticket?
Or oh, yeah, 100%. I just got them, and I was actually 2 weeks ago in Denver for work, saw them out there as well. So, you know, it's going to be twice in 2 weeks, so I'm super stoked about this one.
That's a true fan right there. I can't tell you. Can't tell you how happy. He's going to be talking about this for years. You'll be talking about this for years. Gentlemen, thank you. Tell DragonForce how much you love him.
Love you, DragonForce.
Ready from Gerardo. Just got to see four amazing bands, I believe. And DragonForce, I don't know what else I was expecting, but they went beyond my expectations.
Beyond expectations?
Beyond.
So what were the expectations? Because expectations were pretty high.
Expectations were about, you know, sky's the limit. I mean, they passed the atmosphere and shit, but they passed that. So different universe, different realm.
That's pretty good. So if you were to pick one definitive moment, what was it that really was like, damn, I'm having a great time?
I mean, it's stereotypical, but last song, man, memories up on that arcade machine, and I was like just about right below it, a little bit to the left, and just held it. Looking down,
that's fire. All right, so tell them who you love, man.
Oh, John the Ninja. Oh, your ears are about to go on a vacation. John the Ninja's got what you need.